Hi everybody, welcome to another episode of Fish Keeping Jamaica. Today I will be actually dissecting I'll be showing you my 280 gph submersible pump in which I had in my koi tank a while back, in which have actually stopped working. I will explain to you the different parts of it and the functions, and I will also share with you factors which may contribute to it stop working as it should. Now, this submersible pump comes with several different valves for the different holes in which you may choose to actually use on your pump. Now, this is just one of the holes that I actually used while this pump was in use. Now, this pump, right, it comes with a sponge, and if you can remember the last video in which I share with you being in the home center, where I looked at a newer version to this, and I said that I will be getting it in December, right? I have not gotten it as yet, but this is practically what it looks like. What happened is that there's a sponge-like thing that fits here, right? This supposedly should be the switch which actually turns it and help to gauge the amount of water which actually goes through. Now, this is what actually is used to pump the water, right? Now, what will happen is that the entire thing right here magnetic, right? So when you plug in this into the socket, what will happen is that the current along with the magnet will have this spinning, right? It sucks the water in here. So this is placed over this with a sponge in it, right? Now it sucks the water in through these areas, right? And the water goes in, then it comes out here, it goes into the filtration system, and then it goes back into the container, right? So therefore the water is continuously being circulated, thus oxygenating the water, and also serve as a means of filtering the debris that may exist within the water. Okay, now I bought this pump some years ago, I think 2015, right? I bought this 2015 thereabout, right? And I placed it in my pond, and what happened is that I managed it improperly. Now what happened is that with submersible pump, the water is actually the pump is actually submerged into the container, right? And you would periodically take out the pump so as to actually maintain it, you know, pull it up. So you would pull it, right? You would take out this, and this is something that you have to do when you have a submersible pump. Periodically you have to do this, always you'll find that the water flow that comes out here is gonna be decreasing, right? And then you'll clean off the gunk off of this thing, right? And then you pull it in, and so many times you might have gunk that is stuck in between the valves here. You have to clean it, and there's a sponge thing that exits here. What I did with mine was to use some PVC adhesive to actually fix this in place. I actually broke off one of the valve intentionally because I just wanted the water to be circulating very fast. I never wanted a gauge that restrict the water, right? I took out the sponge, so therefore the water was continuously being taken up and carried to the filter container, which will actually do one thing instead of having it being pre-filtered, then it being filtered, because that means I would have to actually be cleaning this on a regular basis. And the fish that was in this was goldfish and koi, and you all know that goldfish and koi actually excrete a lot of waste. Okay, so what happened is that when I am maintaining my pond. I made some really bad, well, I made a really bad choice of getting it out. What I did was to actually, when the pump is at the bottom of the pond, I usually just hold the pump like this with the hose on it and just take it out of the pond itself. Now, after doing that for nearly 2 years, what happened, what I found is that there has been a short here. Now, what this short does, it works still, you know, but it is inconsistent. Let's say that light actually, I have a light surge, or light actually go away, right? What you'll find is that I would have to come out in the night during rain or whatever, and I will actually have to jumpstart this lever by actually pushing it down, right, or spinning it for it to actually chip in. It was really proving really difficult for me at a certain point in time. Thus, I have just abandoned it and purchased a different one, right? A much smaller one, 180, but it still works. Now, I'm just going to plug it in for a short bit. Don't know if it will actually chip in, but this is what happened. Now, because I was drawing it all along, what happened is that they got caught. Wearing it is. Is actually it's working, right? And the metal thing that's supposed to be in it is not clear. I purchased one and it was ceramic and it broke, right? So this pump actually works, but it's just not working to my standard. And I think I might run the risk of electrocuting my fish, because the wire is actually broken here, and I have no knowledge as to how to fix it to make it waterproof. So if you know how to fix it to make it waterproof, you just let me know. But this pump really works really well, right? And it would make the bottom of my koi and my goldfish pond really clean. I mean, clean like this, right? The bottom of the pond will like be clean, right? Because it was like the black 55 gallon jump, and this was placed in it, and the water usually come up into the hose, go into a liquor pond with some sponge and stones, and the water that is actually released back into the pond was really good. It was really clean. The parameters were excellent. So I'm looking forward to purchase another one like this. Now, one thing to know is that what I just did a while ago should not be done, in the sense that I should not have plugged in this submersible pond without it being in water. Because what happened is that when it's being plugged in without water, the system inside of this, in actually managing my pump, cost me. And when I bought this pump, it was like 7,500 for it in total, including tax, right? In Jamaica, that is, right? If you want to know how much is it in US dollars, US currency, you would have to divide that by 126.44, which is the current exchange rate, right? So this submersible pump, and so remember, GPH on a submersible pump, or GPH on a pump, suggests the gallons per hour in which it actually pass through the pump itself. Therefore, the pump gets rated by that. So therefore, this pump actually still work. I just don't know how to fix it, right? So I just put it one side and I got others. Now, should in case you have a submersible pump and you were unaware as to the damage that you may cause when actually taking or removing your pump from the pond or tank for maintenance, the best thing to do is to remove the submersible pump by virtue of holding the hose or whatever gadget actually the water is actually attached to the pump itself. So you will hold it hose, right, and you actually pull it out of the water. Do not hold it by the cord, because after a while this will end up happening, right? I can see where the shorts is there, like in the night, in the dark, when I like move the wire, you will see right here at the white section, it just start gash, like inside of the cord is getting really red. So I just leave it alone. I am not an electrician, so I just leave it alone. But that's it, as far as my submersible pump goes. Presently I have a 360 gallon 360 gph submersible pump, and two 180 gph pump, which actually is used to manage my IBC tote, in which I know it should be at least a 280, meaning that I have an average of 240 gallons in it. However, for the time being, that's what I use. And point to note, these pumps along with the air pumps parts are sold for them. So therefore, if you find that this section have actually gone bad, it's worn, right? So the magnetic, the metal that actually goes around it is no longer working as it should, right? You can actually go online, or you can go to your pet shop, and you can actually show them this one, the one that you have, and ask them to match it, and it should work. And it should have a metal thing in here, which actually helps to keep it inside, and then you'll have a seating that sits over it, which keeps it in place. Mine has actually broken, so therefore it's not there, but it still works, right? The only thing is that it makes a little noise whenever it is in operation. So ladies and gentlemen, thank you for making the fish keep in Jamaica. Do have a wonderful day. I hope that this video was interesting and informative, and I hope that you won't make the same mistake by holding your cord. Ensure that you do regular maintenance on your submersible pump. Whatever pump you have, whether it be submersible or external, maintenance is necessary so as to ensure that it works properly as all you wish. Thank you very much. Bye bye.